So we're getting ready to go to Ship Island, which I was trying to see if there's anything that says Ship Island behind us, but...
The boat says Ship Island.
Really?
Yeah. And
I can't see anything because the sun's like right in my eyes, so hopefully I got something. But so we're going to go to Ship Island. It's off the coast of Gulfport and Biloxi, Mississippi. What's out at Ship Island?
It's 11 miles out there. You're supposed to be able to see dolphins on the way.
Which that's one of the big reasons.
And a lot of boats and shipping stuff. And there's a fort out there, Fort Massachusetts.
Now,
you get to tour that, and then the island is just supposed to have clear, awesome beach water and shelling and birding. And
this probably isn't for most families, because this is, we dropped $135 to get all of our crew, which we have a 13-year-old, a 16-year-old, and a 9-year-old, plus two adults.
One adult, basically, or one child and four adult tickets.
So it probably isn't for every family if you're vacationing on a budget, but this is like the only thing that we really did besides go to the beach. But we're hoping to have a lot of fun. We'll show you a little bit of it. Okay, now have a heart-to-heart, mama. It's day 3 of vacationing.
Day four,
and we've been inside. We've been staying at a Days Inn, and so it's a small room with 5 people in it. So, if anyone had trauma behaviors or any quirks, you're right there, close and personal with all of them. So, what do you think?
It was a little rough.
A little rough. The magic of video editing.
Yep, I can't say that I didn't shed a few tears.
Mama had a little crying. So we're gonna try to have a good day today, and we're going to be going, after we get done at the island, we're gonna be going, what time does it end?
We board to come back at 2:30, and it's about a 50 minute ride.
Okay, so then after that, we're going to be heading straight to Birmingham, Alabama, which is halfway home. And then we'll get up Friday, and we've got a ton of transfiguring adoption work to do on Friday, so as soon as we get home, we won't even get to rest. When we get home, we'll be hitting the ground running. Tell us the funny thing you found out about the tickets that we have for the ferry to Ship Island.
We have to have them for the ride back.
Which is just funny because if you lose them...
Do they not let you back on? Because, I mean, it's 11 miles out in the ocean. It's not
that means
like
you're stuck on the island.
Back.
And if you lose them, like, can you not go up to the ferry and be like, how else would I have gotten here? Thank you. name of the port?
Port Massachusetts, I think.
Port Massachusetts, and then there's just fun stuff. We saw, how many dolphins do we see?
I found
100.
Was a baby. 8 or 9.
Yeah, I found 100.
I saw one baby. I know, because there were 2 dolphins and one of them has
a baby. Mommy, I started out with me finding 10. Then I...
You saw the baby, didn't you, Matthew?
Then I found 9.
I don't know.
Well, there were 2 right next to each other, and one looked really small compared to the other, so... It looked like it was likely.
So I wonder what other wildlife we'll see.
There must be a lot of birds out here.
Would you feed an alligator if you could?
Daddy. Huh? That's the first thing why you should not feed an alligator, since they don't come out in the day.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
I think they might.
Yeah, they might, only if they see a big shark to run away from it.
Would you feed them?
Sure. No.
That's good.
Question would be, why in the world would they build a fort out on Ship Island? Well, I've got a couple of pages of history to share with you about that. Let's take a quantum leap. Let's jump back over 300 years. Out here on this island with no name, and what do we see? Can you imagine a squadron of French ships coming around this west tip of this island? And drop an anchor right back here along this north shore. Pierre Le Moyne d'Abbeville has arrived with the orders from the King of France to come to this area right in here. And above all, find the mouth of the Mississippi River. We're going to colonize area, this area. That's why they're here. The King of France has already claimed everything drained by the Mississippi River is French territory. So here they are. In history, if you start digging a little bit, you can find so many interesting things. In this case, I found that the pilot, the navigator on the lead ship that brought them here to this particular island, his name was De Graaf. Can you guess what Mr. De Graaf's former occupation had been? No, pirate, a buccaneer. This became a very, very busy island, all during the 1700s. The French built warehouses out here. This was the port of entry for New Orleans. They did not try to sail those wooden sailing ships up the Mississippi to get to New Orleans. This is where they came. December 1814. This is during the War of 1812. Can you imagine 50 British ships of the line come around this west tip and drop an anchor? So many ships, some were over toward Cat Island over there as well. The British have arrived on Ship Island. The Redcoats are here. What's going on? These same Redcoats were some of Great Britain's finest troops. They've never been defeated in battles. They go across the Mississippi Sound, on into Lake Bourne, to its southern shores, through the Bayou country. They came out south of New Orleans at the location that's referred to as Chalmette Plantation, where the battle was fought early January 1815. We all know the results of that battle. This was a great victory for this young United States, wasn't it? So in this case, the British came back out here licking their wounds after that battle. President Madison said this is never going to happen again. This is the second time we've been invaded by a foreign power. We've got to do better than that. Congress agreed. So they planned what was referred to at that time, third stage of fortifications for this United States. You're now in the last of the forts that were built. 34 were completed, and this is the 34th one. Another thing is, hot shot furnace over here. It's not for barbecuing on Sunday afternoon. We can use 6-inch or 8-inch solid cannonballs. And we put them in the rack right there on this end, there at that opening in the furnace. We'd have an ordnance sergeant out here that would be stoking that furnace with coal. 75 minutes later, these red hot cannonballs are ready to fire at the wooden sailing ship. Now, why would you want to do that? Wooden sailing ships were highly flammable. And it was a proven method. In fact, they even were using it back during the War of 1812 as well. So it's an old method. But every fort normally had a hot shot furnace. Men are missing, but we still have ours. Port. We'll pass that position in a minute. We put in two 100-pound pair of rifles with a range of 5 miles. So there they were with a total of 17 mounted. And then they also assigned one ordnance sergeant out here to take care of the fort, keep the cannon at rest in case it was needed. And here he was. His only neighbor was the lighthouse keeper family next door. 1901 rolled around. Gentlemen, looking at the budget for the new year. What in the world is the ordnance sergeant salary doing out there at Ship Island? They said, well, he's out here taking care of a bunch of obsolete cannon. Well, if we get rid of the cannon, we'll get rid of that salary of the ordnance sergeant, and we'll pay the lighthouse keeper $5 more a month to take care of the fort. That action was taken. So right to pay in the government, he came out here in the schooner as close as he could to shore. Started drilling holes in the cannon, as you can see. Inserting sticks of dynamite. Blowing up the cannon to small pieces, small enough they could pick up, load on the schooner, took it to the mainland, sold for scrap iron. So that's what happened to the cannon at Ship Island.
Handy-dandy picnic areas here, and Margie made fluffer nutter sandwiches, which is peanut butter with marshmallow cream. And good idea, except mine all melted. So I've been eating the marshmallow cream off my sandwich bag. Good stuff. So it's kind of nice because we just stayed at a picnic area and there's a restroom on the island. A couple of them. Looks like there's a snack bar. It's nice, really nice boardwalk.
Or restrooms on the boats.
Restrooms are on the boats, yes. And then there's a really long boardwalk that takes us back to the ship. Oh, and we got beach safety.
Be aware of stingrays. Shuffle your feet while wading. Avoid grass beds and murky water.
Don't you have fun?
Yeah.
Yeah? that water is so clear.
I know, it's gorgeous.
So you having fun?
Absolutely.
So you're seeing dolphins. Dalton's a little nervous and apprehensive, I'm noticing, but he really wants in, but he's really scared to get in.
It's always like this with like the ocean and even pools, like
sensory processing fun.
Yep. Once he warms up, he doesn't want to get out.
I'm scared that I'm going to be burnt to a crisp because I am like mayonnaise man. Like, because my work is always by the computer with transfiguring adoption and different things, so I am so white. And Margie always tans really nice. And
yeah, except for yesterday. Like, there were a couple spots I missed with the sunscreen. Like, I have a stripe on the inside of my leg.
Oh, we were really walking hurts. Here. I got a video of it because we were walking here, and you can see the stripe on your back. It doesn't look bad. It's just kind of like...
On my back? There's one. I'm talking about the one on my leg. I didn't see one on my back.
Yeah, you have one on your back.
Nice.
Where the suit was it? So, and Matthew's got his snorkel out there, so I'm gonna go put the camera away so I can go get out in the water a little bit because it looks really clear. I wanna see if I can see some dolphins, and maybe we'll video some more here after a while because we're here for a few more hours. Jellyfish that have come to shore.
There's a whole line of them.
There is a whole line of them. Look at that. They're like all over the stinking place. So, we're heading back to the ship. We had fun. It was just really cool. It was really clean. We didn't know, like, the restrooms have, like, showers in them, like, warm water in them. And, like Margie was saying, like, we totally would have brought clean clothes and stuff like that to change into for the ride back. We were just planning on air drying and just wearing our swimsuits and stuff like that back to the shore. But if we'd known they had showers, we'd have totally brought clothes and been ready to like head back to Alabama. Yeah, Alabama, Birmingham tonight in clean clothes. But there's a snack shop there. You could rent umbrellas and chairs and different things. It was a fun trip. Would you suggest this to people?
Oh yeah. Blast. We saw so many interesting things. Even while we were swimming, we could watch dolphins playing, and there were crabs and jellyfish. And
I actually found an exoskeleton crab.
Exoskeleton of a crab?
Yeah, of a crab. Two of them.
So
I didn't find a starfish.
Yeah, it was. I think we'd definitely suggest this to people. Again,
it was like a little lagoon where there were a bunch of fish jumping out. Mm-hmm. It was neat to watch.
Bit pricey though.
Yeah,
you do have
a bit
to
pricey for the ferry out here, but yeah. A lot of fun. So
you do have to watch.
We'll see you on the other side. Look at all those manta rays coming here. Stingrays, I mean.
are on our last day of fall break, which basically we're just driving home. We finished our fun day yesterday and had some dinner near the beach and got back in the car, drove to Birmingham. And I just wanted to show you all the hotel and the difference between this hotel and the last hotel. Whereas the last one said it slept five and it just had two beds, this one also said it slept five. It has the two beds, only these are queens as opposed to the full-size beds in the last hotel. This one actually has a windowed seat that doubles as a little bed. Jasmine slept there and it was quite nice. Have a nice view out there. We actually have a refrigerator in this one. Would have been nice to have that all this week. Refrigerator, microwave, quite a bit of just storage, a nice long desk with two chairs. The bathroom is being utilized right now, but it's quite nice too. Just all in all, it's the Microtel by Wyndham.
It's right by a Walmart too.
Yeah, there's right by, like, there's a Walmart, there's Starbucks, Walmart. There's
a lot of stuff nearby. So it's nice because I'm sitting there thinking with a trip like trips like we do, if like you forgot something, you could just go over to Walmart. Or like we were down at the beach and like Jasmine's sandals broke on her and my flip-flops broke on me. Like, we could just go over to Walmart and get stuff. It's just so nice and handy. And I feel like everything is clean here. Like, it's very, very, like, I wasn't scared to sleep in the bed or anything like that.
Yeah, the breakfast was nice.
Breakfast was really nice.
It looks like there's a nice pool outside. Of course, we're hitting the road to get back home. We've got an event tonight that we're vending at, so we're just trying to hurry up and get back so we're not doing a whole lot, but there was actually some protein at this breakfast as opposed to the last breakfast we went to at the last hotel. So this is the Microtel by Wyndham in Gardendale, Alabama. So we're kind of off on the northeast side of Birmingham. So yeah, just a great place to stay.